Good evening and welcome to Charles Bland Stadium. I'm Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice, and we have Middle College High School out of Memphis, Tennessee here not visiting the Bearcats. And Lloyd, should be a good night of football.
Should be a real good night, Kevin. Look forward to getting past this sultry Louisiana-like weather, sure. But I'm glad these guys came up to us to fill this Charleston game spot.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, the humidity's as thick as the mosquitoes, and it's going to be a good night. I think it'll cool down once we get the sun behind us. The Bearcats just now taking the field. You'll see on your camera here in a second, Middle College coming in. And we don't know much about this team. I know it's their football program's fairly new, but it's a private school, 200 students, 9 through 12, part of the Christian Brothers College program. But they come into the tonight 3-0, putting up 42 points in one game and 49 in another, but we don't know much about the opponents.
Kevin, they've definitely crossed into the end zone more than we have this year. That's a lot of points. Word is we're going to be fast on the edges, and we better be stopping anything getting to the outside, or it's going to be a track meet.
Oh, yeah, and they look good warm up as the Bearcats. The Bearcats still without Jason Gerald, still without Corbin Strong. And then Jake Adams also, three starters, three playmakers. So, that could play into account tonight. And you'll see your captains there about to take the field. Is number 41, Bo McMullen. Number 85, Nick Trout. Number 11, Peyton Tennant. And number 72, Garrison Collier.
And, boy, didn't Tennant have a good weekend last Friday. Uh-huh. Really ran confident. I knew two plays into the game Peyton was going to have a really good night. Ran with a ton of confidence and really spread that out over the four quarters of football. We had a nice game last Friday night.
Yes, we did. Peyton was one that I'd noticed in the jamboree, and I said, this guy has the potential to have a big year for the Bearcats. So as we get to the coin toss, we've got a little Bearcat intro here for you, and we'll be back in just one moment.
Jake Adams, senior, number 4.
Ethan Martinez, senior, number 1.
Jason Gerald, senior, number 10.
Blake Palmer, senior, number 5.
Peyton Tennant, number 11, senior.
Corey Holland, senior, 51.
Will McMullen, junior, number 41.
Trevor McDonald, junior, 26.
Nick Trout, junior, number 85.
Chris Reinhart, junior, number 22.
Ben Sindel, junior, 14.
Christian Yarber, junior, number 64.
Gabe Jackson, junior, 35.
Austin Adams, junior, 45.
Jake Rice, junior, number 15.
Landon Henson, junior, number 30.
Corbin Strong, sophomore, 31.
Jet Featherston, sophomore, 44.
Caleb Hoggard, sophomore, 16.
Dalton Warren, sophomore, 42.
Garrison Collier, sophomore, number 72.
Jake Harris, sophomore, 76.
Luke Boyer, sophomore, 78.
Hunter Lawrence, sophomore, 34.
Ernesto Rivera, sophomore, number 3.
Seth Rogers, sophomore, number 21.
Braxton Foster, sophomore, number 40.
Colton Gibson, sophomore, number 68.
Nate Gargis, sophomore, number 12.
Joe Rice, sophomore, number 9.
Brock Simmons, sophomore, number 74.
And we're back at Charles Bland Stadium as the coin toss has just taken place. The Bearcats did win the coin toss, and they have elected to receive. Okay. I was just about to make a comment that's not normal.
That never happens.
Yeah, I mean, normally we defer, and that is what we did. The Bearcats won the coin toss, and they'll defer to the second half. So Bearcats need to come out strong early, don't they, Lloyd?
Absolutely. Need to have that real confident start, because I'm telling you, Kevin, Friday at New Madrid, that was the key component in the game. They ran strong early. We got some points on the board early, and that confidence level just shot through the roof for our ball carriers. You could just sense it all over. Spilled right on out through the game. Nick Trout's catching passes. It was a good night for him, and all predicated on that really good start.
Well, and you know, Middle College, I know 3-hour drive at least. They're in Midtown Memphis, right down by the Liberty Bowl. You know, these guys, they don't want to drive 3 hours to lose. They'd love to come into Charles Bland Stadium, put a good old-fashioned butt-whooping on the Bearcats,
yes.
So we better come out quick.
You're right, and we do. We need to give them some of that grinded out, a good, you know, football word punch in the mouth, and get after it here.
Well, Jason Gerald will be kicking tonight, although I think that's the only duties he's going to handle.
Yep.
Let's get ready to
best shoes on the field,
oh,
Kevin.
Yeah. And we onside it right off the bat, but unfortunately right to number 34. We'll see who that is. That's going to be Edric Cole. And he is a freshman, 175-pound freshman.
Big freshman.
Well, this defensive line for the Bearcats have shown moments of being very hard to stop. You know, early on, if they can get in the backfield.
Right.
It'll get you pumped up.
See Braxton Foster out there on the end, giving us a little different look tonight. Kevin, I'd say he earned that spot last Friday,
yep,
too. Uh-oh.
Well, quick. Some of that speed that
yep,
we talked about early. Looks like we had Gabe Jackson. Came in a little quick off the end, and that's a dangerous spot
yep,
to be in. It can happen a lot of times if you get a bad angle.
Sucked in a little bit of a bad angle, and you know, we said it. That's the one thing on tape they show. Out on the edges, they're going to be really fast.
Well, looking down here at the near side, they've got a receiver that's about as thick as any receiver I've seen. We'll see what the call is on the field. And I think we're just making
equipment.
An equipment adjustment.
Do you get that early? That's like a do-over?
Yeah, just three down linemen. Gabe Jackson comes hard again. Good job
Hang
by
on.
The Bearcats.
There you go. That away, Bo. I think they're going to be really aggressive to do that. From watching tape
yeah,
and hearing Joe talk about what they're talking about during the week, it's going to be blitzing and coming pretty hard and fast.
Well, these are, you know, type of guys you can't set back and wait on.
Right,
them. I mean,
exactly.
They're going to have the speed. You're right.
Kind of force the issue.
Bearcats come out in the same look as Middle College spreads it out. First pass of the game,
there
intercepted, and it may go to the house by Nick
Hurry,
Trout.
Nick.
He's at the 40, the
Lay
30,
one block
the 20.
Down.
The
Get
10.
In there, Nick.
He's going to make a cut, and he scores.
Attaway.
Touchdown, Bearcats.
That's
what we needed.
That is a good start right there. That'll help Nick with a lot of confidence. That's a big defensive play for them guys.
This crowd loves every second of it. As he returned it 60 yards for the touchdown. I know Hank and Renee probably out of their seats. Big play by the junior.
That's the one we've been looking for.
Yeah, it is. Just like that, with 10:41 to go in the first quarter, the Bearcats lead 6-0. And you got to thank Middle College. I know it's early. It's stunned a little bit right there.
That's right.
I mean, if you look back at the Bluff game, opening kickoff ran back,
we
were stunned.
We got a dose of that, right?
Yeah.
It's like Gabe's in on special teams. Didn't realize it.
Yep. And these guys are fired up on the sideline, as they should be. The Bearcats are going to go for two. Sindel under center. He hands it off up the middle.
Hoggard.
To Caleb Hoggard, and it's good. Hoggard,
you know,
a sophomore.
Kevin, that was another guy last week that really ran early with confidence, and earned this spot tonight, I promise you, because of it.
Well, Caleb, you know, had a great middle school career, ran the ball hard and well, and he was one that, you know, we thought could be a good Bearcat for us one day, and he's getting to play a little bit early.
It's a fun start.
And tonight's game is brought to you in part by Bagby Wealth Management and Dexter. Bagby Wealth Management is a fee-based advisory firm that specializes in giving investment advice, management, and financial planning services. When you're ready to pursue your investment goals, give them a call at 573-624-4771. And I'm sure Mr. Gargis would appreciate that call. You know, Ed, with us a lot of times, out of town tonight. So if you're listening, Ed, we've already got several calls that you're missed.
No question.
No question. Well, the Bearcats lead 8-0, 10:41 to go here in the first quarter. And we kick it deep. Middle College will receive it at about the 7-yard line. Not able to find a seam. Bearcats, good coverage.
Good coverage, guys. Way to break that up.
Big stick by Austin Adams, the younger brother of Jake Adams there.
Got a flag in the backfield here, Kevin. What would that back judge have called?
Be an odd place for a flag. Unless there was a hold.
Penalty flag on the play.
Personal foul. And that's Bearcats. Yeah, but unfortunately the Bearcats are gonna get, you know, good coverage, but they're gonna get stuck with a 15-yard penalty because there was a personal foul call. And my guess might have been a little bit of excessive celebration. I mean, it's the only thing I can figure. It's early in the game. These guys are fired up. Good stick there by Austin Adams. And if you're just tuning in, we're coming off of about a 60-yard interception return for a touchdown by the junior Nick Trout. It'll be first and 10 for Middle College. Hand off up the middle. Bearcats cover it well, but give him a seam, and Peyton Tennant.
There you go, Peyton.
Big stick.
That goes the ball carrier. Brought down by number 11, Peyton Tennant.
Peyton said, not in my house. And that's a big read there by Peyton. I mean,
absolutely.
Come up from the safety position, make a big stick.
So what are we doing here, Kevin? Is this a little bit of a four down and?
Yeah, it's more of a kind of a 4-3 look.
Okay.
Although Gabe's
that's
not getting
a
down
different
the 3-point
look.
Stance.
That's a change from where we've been. Play clock should be.
Delay a game.
Yeah.
And Lord, you're right. Delay a game, so 5-yard penalty.
It's easy to see on that new Nevco game clock clicking off.
So it's going to be second and about 12 for the Bulldogs. They're going to pass again. Goes deep.
Whoa, throw it to us again. Had a baby.
Intercepted again. They're going to say he stepped out of bounds.
Nate Gargis, there you go.
And Ed, if you're watching, big interception by the boy, Nate Gargis.
Tell you what, that wasn't just thrown to him, Kevin. He had to go chase that down. It's a good play, Nate Gargis.
Yeah, great play. I mean, hard to stay in bounds. That ball was selling out quick. So early on.
Look at them corners taking care of business here.
Early on, two interceptions by the Bearcats. And we'll see the first action tonight from our offense outside of the two-point conversion. Sindel hands off to, looks like might have been Tennant. Yeah, that's going to be Peyton Tennant, and he picks up about 4 yards.
Ball carrier. Second and 6 for the Bearcats.
So Lloyd, we've kind of got that start we wanted. We'll see if that momentum carries forward. Hand off to Hoggard. He makes a cut. He's going to get the first down
and
four.
Had him run hard.
Caleb Hoggard, the ball carrier. His run good for Bearcat first down. Hoggard brought down by number 66, Christopher Difference.
So first down for the Bearcats. Two offensive plays, positive yardage on both. We'll see how long it'll be before they try to get the ball in the hands of Big Gabe Jackson.
Stacked up pretty tight right now.
Yeah. Peyton gets the outside. He's at the 30. Makes a move down at the 20. He fumbles.
Probably
going to
call
say
him
he's
down. Good deal.
And the ground calls the fumble. Good call by the official.
He was ruled down. His run good for Bearcat. First down. Number six on the stop, Deshaun Davis.
It's Peyton Kennan with the big gain, and it'll be first down Bearcats at about the 20-yard line.
Well, Kevin, we sucked him right in on that last series.
Yes, we did. And Hoggard, he'll pick up just about a half yard on the carry.
He was brought down by number seven, Tyrus Moore. Second nine for the Bearcats.
It's going to be a second and a long nine for the Bearcats. Hunter Lawrence in the backfield at fullback. Tenen in motion. He takes the pitch.
One block there. There you go. Good read on it, Peyton.
I think he may have got – he got the first down.
That was a good read on that block, and Peyton's confident level just soaring right now. What a good couple of weeks he's got going here.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, he made an excellent cut there reading the blocks. The Bearcats threat to punch it in again for their second score of the night. 7:40 to go here in the first quarter. They lead 8-0, and Hunter Lawrence at fullback, Sindel underneath. Motion by McDonald.
We're in again. Nope, stopped short.
McDonald picks up about 5 to 6 yards. Trevor been a good addition to these Bearcats this year. Let's set
has,
out last year.
Has, especially when Trevor figures out that you got to leave some of the extracurricular stuff away from it. A real positive addition to the running game. Coach Goltra is dedicated to that and needs about a six-prong approach to it, and he needs to be a big part of that.
They're going to be stopped short, but positive yardage. It's going to be third and about third, and they're going to lock about 3 yards. Third and goal, 3 yards to punch it in. Right now we've seen Sindel under center with McDonald and Tenen at the wing backs, Hunter Lawrence at fullback. Bearcats take their time in the huddle. We got a receiver out wide, number three, Ernesto Riviera, and we pitch it to McDonald. He makes a cut. He's in for the score.
Yeah. Tell you one thing, Trevor's not as scared to stick his neck out there for all 130 pounds of him or whatever there is. There's he runs with reckless abandon for sure.
Yeah, he does. Bearcats mixed it up a little bit that time, had a receiver out wide. So the Bearcats lead 14-0, and it looks like they're going to go for the two-point conversion once again. Motion by McDonald. Sindel's back. He's got a guy wide open.
Well,
and
sure
Hunter Lawrence just drops it. But good look by
good
Sindel.
Look.
Good,
right.
Good execution.
Well done, man. Good series there. Give Kevin a chance to play some of that good 80s rock and roll now.
If you take a nice look at the field tonight, you should be impressed as it's in great condition thanks to Turf Renovations. Turf Renovations is responsible for outstanding field surfaces on not only this field, but numerous ones in the area, such as Dexter, Sykeston, Portageville, and area baseball fields as well. Turf Renovation prides themselves on providing the best playing surface possible for the area's athletes. Special thanks to Turf Renovations, and to check out their projects, go to turfrenovations.com. And the field does look outstanding.
Outstanding. Ben, I was going to say, Kevin, has looked good all summer and all fall. They're in the middle of the project down at the park right now for us, and been a pretty exciting time with Mr. Wood and some of his ideals on fields in Dexter.
Gerald, short kick. Middle College picks it up late. Good coverage by the Bearcats, but he's still on his feet. He's going to the outside. He gets a little bit of an edge.
One block will give you a problem there, won't
there,
it, Kevin?
Oh, big hit.
Oh, hello. Going to get a flag there, too.
Looks like that was Austin Adams again.
He was brought down by number 45, Mr. Austin Adams.
That was a lot of plastic crashing.
Yeah. All right, we got a timeout, so we'll be back in one moment.
Fusion, the newest name in in-home care, providing assistance with any activity of daily living in the comfort and safety of your own home, including personal care, homemaker services, respite services, professional nurse visits, medication setup, and diabetic nail care. If you or someone you know is in need of care in their own home so they can remain there independently, then call us today. We serve New Madrid, Dunklin, and Stoddard counties. Fusion in-home care, building our family with yours.
Hi, I'm Shane Horner.
Hi, I'm Tim Ellison.
Hi, my name is Richard Clark.
I'm Lori Amos.
I'm Rob Blackwell.
And I'm Ryan DeSetti.
Hi, I'm Alan King.
Hello, I'm Larry Ellison, and we're proud to be part of the Harry Blackwell Ford family here in Malden, Missouri.
All right, we're back at Charles Bland Stadium as the Dexter Bearcats have took the early lead 14-0. With 6 minutes to go here in the first quarter, started out with a 60-yard interception return for a touchdown, and then in about six plays, the Bearcat offense was able to punch it in on the last score.
Two good series.
Yeah.
Really moved the ball well, ran what we want to run.
Bearcats in the backfield, but push him outside,
uh-oh,
and there's a flag. It's
going to
be a hold.
Kevin,
I think it's coming back.
There you go.
But nice job there by number 33.
That's Hayden Hillis, wasn't it?
Hayden Hillis.
There you go.
Chasing him down.
Penalty flag on the play.
And it will be a hold against Middle College, so that play will be negated.
That run will come back.
It's a nice break for the Bearcats as Middle College was down at about the 15-yard line on the big run. And that's where they can be dangerous. We talked about that speed.
Yep. Getting to the younger secondary force there where we're a little more suspect, Kevin. We don't hit quite as heavy there. And
you look at our two safeties there. Hayden Hillis, freshman. Seth Rogers, a sophomore.
About 200 pounds between them. And,
yeah.
Fast and aggressive, but it is what it is.
Yep.
So
we've talked about it every week, but this Bearcat team, young through and through. I mean, look at their defensive line. You got a junior, one senior, and then a couple of sophomores. Good job by Hayden Hillis coming up to make the tackle again. He was assisted by Bo McMullen along with Nick Trout.
Had a little bit of read on it that time, didn't we?
Yeah.
Along with number 44,
Jake Featherston. Helping out at the middle linebacker responsibilities tonight, also in on that tackle. So it's going to be second and about 16 for the Bulldogs. Nice crowd on hand tonight, Lloyd. A lot of red and black across.
Absolutely.
From us.
Had a little Miss DHS action early, so.
Congratulations to all the contestants. Ashlyn Wyman crowned Miss DHS 2016, and the yellow out pass.
Hey, well, when they do get the ball, Kevin, on the edges, a little bit of room to run.
Yep.
That's.
Well, they were able to pick up about 12 yards on the little swing pass. And if many that watched the Piper Bluff game, man, I think they ran that play over and over and over. We never could defend it real well.
Five different quarterbacks, too.
Yeah.
It was a long evening.
Middle College comes in again, 3-0 tonight. The Bearcats setting at 1-2, so a chance to get back to 500 tonight. Defended well there.
It was. Good read, fellas.
Braxton crashed down on the quarterback, yep. And then Bo McMullen cleaned up the tailback.
That is so tempting for him not to all,
oh, yeah.
You know, overextend, get a little too aggressive, and that plays big yardage on us.
See number 78, Luke Boyer, the big sophomore. Coach Gocher is going to give him a break. And we've got a timeout, Middle College. We'll be right back to Charles Bland Stadium.
My name is Dustin Mayer. I operate Mayer Law Office, which is a full-service law firm located in Dexter, Missouri. I practice personal injury, criminal defense, workers' compensation, family, and other areas of law. As an assistant Missouri Attorney General and assistant prosecuting attorney, I've had the opportunity to try multiple cases in front of juries, and I'm willing to put that experience to work on your behalf. I'm a Southeast Missouri native, and if you hire me, you'll get the big firm experience with a small town touch. Call today for your free consultation.
What is your emergency?
Need assistance at County Road 61 and Highway 9.
Help is on its way.
Clear!
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
And welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium as we're coming off a timeout by the Middle College Bulldogs. They wanted to talk about this fourth down play as they're going to go for it. Bearcats lead 14-0. They're going to drop back. No good sack. And a big play.
Good
man. But number 35, Gabe Jackson, the big guy.
He has been such a load.
Oh, man.
Really, against all the teams we played. But he just had a field day last Friday down at New Madrid.
Yeah, I can only imagine.
And I can tell that he's chomping at the bits tonight, too.
Gabe, big basketball player here in Dexter, just – kind of became not as well known at the beginning of the year last year, but by the end of the year, everybody knew, yep, who Gabe Jackson was, and they were doubling on him, triple team sometimes. So, big, tough kid, but also has some of the softest hands probably in the Boot Hill.
Good hand. That's kind of his calling card. He never loses the ball.
Hand off to Lawrence.
There's
and
Hunter.
He's
going to
pick
run.
Up about 11 atta yards.
Baby. Good block downfield there by Tennant leading the way.
Hunter Lawrence, the ball carrier. He was brought down by
number three from Middle College, has had enough for a minute.
Bearcats so far, positive yardage every play on offense. This time we're going to split a receiver out right wide. Ernesto Riviera, last time we did this, we still ran the ball. Hoggard in motion. Pitch to Hoggard. He takes it outside. He's going to get close to the first down. They're going to call him about a yard short, so about a 9-yard pickup by the sophomore Caleb Hoggard.
Garrison was one half step away from probably a good block and a touchdown.
So second and short here for the Bearcats. And if you're a coach, you always want second and three. It opens up the whole playbook.
Yeah, it does. Kind of a pick 'em now. They have a little fun.
Maybe we'll see the Bearcats take a shot downfield.
This would be a good Gabe Jackson pass play.
Hand off up the middle. They're going to
get our first down. And
Hunter Lawrence, the ball carrier, is
wrong. Another first down for the Bearcats is Hunter Lawrence. Picks it up. That's his second carry on this series. Bearcats will break out of the huddle again. Receiver out wide. Lawrence in the backfield. Motion by Tenen. They're going to run a blast right up the Middle College is ready for that.
Yeah.
It's never a good sign when you see your offensive lineman walking back to the pile.
Yeah.
Tenen will have to come off as his helmet came off. McDonald will usher in for him. So the first negative yardage for the Bearcats on the night. Same look, receiver out to the left instead of the right. They're going to pitch it to McDonald. He's got a seam. Somebody had his jersey. He breaks loose.
That's him. Good tight, yeah. Good tight jerseys, Kevin. Yes. You can't tackle with them.
So third and about five is the Bearcats. Have moved the ball down to the Bulldog. We'll call it about 18, 19 yard line. Sindel under center, takes a snap, Hoggard motion, counter play. Yeah. Nothing there, and Sindel sack. I think that was a busted play. Looked like we set up for a counter, and a back might have went the wrong way.
Somebody didn't have the right read on that.
So the first fourth down for the Bearcats tonight. I'm Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice. If you're tuning in, about a minute to go in the first quarter. Bearcats lead 14-0. They were threatening to score, but backed up a little bit here on fourth down. You definitely go for it. Sindel under center. Hoggard in motion. He's going to look the pass. He goes deep to Gabe Jackson.
Gabe. No. Well.
McDonald flew in. Looked like he might have caught the deflected pass.
Well.
Gabe got away with a little bit of a
push. Yeah, I was going
to. He did.
Yeah, you heard me want to say it, but
yeah,
Gabe definitely was offensive pass interference. So,
a little bit
of justice prevails, at least on the – even without the – I'm not sure who should have had an eye on that, but
Gabe said, "I don't get it thrown too much. Give me that ball."
And you know what? On fourth down, what does it matter?
What do you have
to lose? It really just
honestly not a bad throw by Ben Sindel, right where it needed to be.
Probably Ben's best ball of the year, Kevin. He's
great defense there by the Bearcats.
And we stack it up, guys.
A host of Bearcats in on the tackles. I see Bo McMullen, Featherston, Braxton Foster, Corey Holland coming off the field, and the sophomore Luke Boyer coming back on. Luke's grandpa, I know he's happy to see him out there on the field, Mr. Larry Louder, retired teacher, still subs quite a bit.
He does. He gets his max sub hours.
Yep.
He's the first on Heather's call list.
Not sure what's going on down on the field. Is Bearcats having a little bit of a discussion. They're going to let time run out. That's the end of the first quarter. Bearcats lead 14-0. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Tyler Hubrecht, your state representative for the 151st District. The past two sessions that I've served in Jefferson City, I have fought against the attacks on gun rights. I have fought to support a foundation formula that can be fully funded for education. I've also fought for more support for our infrastructure, in which we want in that, and getting more funding for our ports. I am now working to find ways to support our transportation and to fix our highways. I ask for your vote on November the 8th.
We at First National Bank proudly announce our new name, FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
When most banks change their name, new ownership is usually the case. This is not true with First National Bank. We have made the positive decision to streamline and update not only our name, but also our look. We have a fresh new logo, signage, lobby graphics, brochures, the works. with the same great service and friendly faces that you have come to expect and deserve. First National Bank is now FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
Charles Bland Stadium. I'm Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice. If you're just now tuning in, about to kick off the second quarter, and the Bearcats lead the Middle College Bulldogs 14-0.
Give them a little 1-2 punch early, Kevin,
yes.
And here we sit. So
Bearcats another with a chance. And they're hanging on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Braxton Foster.
That was Braxton Foster.
Keyshawn Davis brought down the backfield by number 40, Braxton Foster.
Braxton responsible for probably one of the biggest highlights ever on YHC. Goes back to the JV Stoddard County Tournament. Hit the half-court shot
half-quarter,
at halftime.
Yep.
Unbelievable.
Tell you what, Braxton's had a big 2 weeks. He's probably between freshman JV and what actually saw last Friday. He's played a lot of quarters of football.
Braxton still has, it looks like to me, got a lot of growing to do.
Absolutely.
I mean, he's gonna be a big
lot of upside with Braxton. We're going to get a
looks like they're going to. Good coverage downfield. Jackson in his face. They're going to give him the catch. It was close. And
Davis pass.
Now they're going to mark
incomplete.
It incomplete. So it'll bring up fourth and long. We should see a
punt
here.
For the Bulldogs.
We'll get with you here in just a moment. Our good friend Brett Dorton has been keeping stats for the Bearcats for many, many years. And he's brought us some first quarter stats. Mr. Lloyd Rice will relay to you here in a moment.
If I can read through these from the nerds in the stat zone over there. Five first downs for us in that first quarter, Kevin.
Oh, that's great.
It looked good and felt good, didn't it? That's a good ball control, ball possession quarter for us.
And we got a timeout by Middle College, so we'll be right back.
And folks, if you've not been to the Winchester Place, come in and take a look at this facility. You don't know what you have missed.
We are very proud of this facility. A lot of people do not realize we're here, what we can offer to them, and what a facility we have. And we would like to have people come by anytime and tourist. You won't find a better place to live or better staff to take care of you anywhere Southeast Missouri. I'll guarantee it.
We are located at 400 Winchester Drive. Come down Bowman, and we sit on the corner of Bowman and Winchester.
Rest easy. State Farm agent Chris Brannon is there for you. Call 573-624-1953 today for the service you deserve.
It stands over here. And welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium as Middle College was set up to punt and took a timeout. Looks like they're still in a punt formation. I would hardly doubt we would see a fake right here, but they wanted to talk about it. Looks like number 11, Peyton Tennant's back deep to cover. Low bouncing kick. Tennant picks it up. He's got a hold. We got a flag down. It's probably going to be a hold on the Bearcats.
Yeah. It's about the only reason that flag would get thrown, wouldn't it?
Brought down by number eight.
And Lloyd, you got some first quarter stats over there for us?
I do. Looks like we've got 14. Let me see, 14 rushes for a total of 76 rushing yards in the first quarter there, Kevin. Total offense of 76 yards. And how does that even score officially when we – on the pick six? Is that a defensive
no yards yardage? Are given. No yards given.
Okay. You should.
Yeah, it should.
So if you've got Nick on your fantasy team, you just get defensive points.
Yeah, you get defensive
right.
points.
It's not
That's
good.
It.
Not good. I won't I won't pick him then.
Yeah.
Had the ball for 7 minutes of the first
management.
Quarter. Says a lot about the five first downs. Really controlled it.
Hand off to Lawrence. He makes a cut. As
good
you don't
cut,
see a quarterback
Hunter.
Do a lot.
Hunter Lawrence, the ball carrier.
And he picks up about
Jacob Hammer.
Call it 3 to 4 yards. Yeah, the stats don't really reflect that first half as we our first quarter. I mean, we had two interceptions. The one, like you said, returned 60 yards for a touchdown. And then we had pretty good field position when we took over on the second score.
We did, and then on that last drive, it kind of fizzled a little a little more than – it was a better series than that, I guess you would say.
Yeah, we marched the ball down a little bit, but unable to convert. McDonald on the carry there. It's going to bring up a third and about a yard. So this type of offense, you should be able to pick up a yard every day of the week.
Getting a couple of smart alecky texts from our friends across Cardinal Nation, Kevin. They can't decide what to watch tonight.
Oh,
Cardinal baseball,
choice.
It seems pretty easy to me.
10 in motion, the pitch.
Get around the edge.
And he does. He'll get the first down.
Peyton 10 in the ball carrier. His run, good for Dexter, first down.
Nice job there by Peyton. I mean, they had him pinned up.
They did.
Actually defended.
Good
well.
Read. Bounced it out and ran with his head down. Good job.
Caleb Hoggard will check into the game for Peyton Tennant. So in our backfield, we'll have two juniors.
Hoggard with three carries in the first quarter, Tennant with five for 38 yards to lead the Bearcats so far. And we've really mixed it up on the offense. I mean, Trevor McDonald ran the ball three times, Hunter Lawrence two, Hoggard three, Tennant five.
So second and short there is Lawrence picks up about a yard. Pitch to Hoggard. And he's going to be really close to the first down. If they mark it where they stand, they may measure.
Brought down by number seven, Tyrus Moore.
Looking in there at the middle of their interior, Kevin, that 66 is a big long basketball-looking guy.
And what did they list him at?
Official timeout permission.
6'5". He just not a lot of tall players with Gabe off the field right now. So
we got an official timeout as they will measure. I mean, it's hard to gauge where the chains are right now. It looks like it will be a first down.
It is.
For the Bearcats.
And this is what Mark Nee and them get paid for.
Yeah.
And if it's not – see, that's just horrible chain ganging. It's awful.
Yeah.
It's like 3 foot short.
Ah.
That's a whole yard.
So if you guys are watching out there, that would be Jimmy Aldridge and Mark Nee's fault.
Third down for the Bearcats.
Have to get somebody to speak to Mr. Erhan about the chain gang crew. May come into play. Bill Fisher was on staff tonight,
yeah,
so
Bill,
could
yeah.
be part of the issue.
So third and really short for the Bearcats. Sindel under center. Hoggard motion, fumbles it, but able to pick up the first down.
So what's that call, Kevin, when we have no receivers?
We're in a double tight.
Double tight.
Yep, double tight, two tight ends, two wing backs.
So is that what Sykeston went to a little bit last year, that everybody was kind of all the buzz?
Yep. You know, and really this offense is probably built for a lot of the kids we have. I mean, Dexter's never been known to have a ton of speed. Now, you have to take the Stevens boys out of that equation.
Right.
But
we get the ball snap, we'll have us a penalty. Oh.
And Middle College does a good job defending that as number 32, Mason Keena, the freshman.
Keena, the ball carrier. He was brought down by number 24.
Mason had some really good defensive plays last Friday. He was a big part of several special team stops. Had a nice game last Friday.
And that's just huge for a freshman to get to see.
Absolutely. A little bit out of necessity, but speaks a lot to Mason's skill set. He's multifaceted, runs it as a primary runner on the JV. Does a great job.
McDonald will get the call as he fights forward for about 2-3 yards. So Middle College with two fairly good defensive plays.
I was just going to say, that's a couple of good hits out of the middle linebacker positions.
Looks like Peyton Tennant will check back into the game along with Austin Featherston.
I'm thinking if I'm their staff too, I'm going to try to gobble up some of this game clock, too. That's
Hoggard in motion. Sindel gets back to throw. He had Gabe wide open, but then intercepted by Middle College. Right there is going to be a flag on the play. Sindel had an opportunity to hit Gabe Jackson.
You did, Kevin. It's just too late. Yeah. One of my all-time favorite kids, Jake's good buddy, Ben, and it's just too late. He just hung on to it two steps too long. What is that? On them after the interception.
Yeah, so the interception will stand, but it's going to be a block in the back, so they're going to have to cover a lot of ground to get to the end zone.
What do you go back? Is that a spot foul? Okay.
Yeah, it'll be half the distance.
That would be at the 1 foot line.
Yeah. And we've got an official timeout, so we'll be right back to Charles Bland Stadium in a moment.
Introducing Pizza Hut's first $5 flavor menu. Just $5 each when you order two or more. Say yes to a medium one-topping pizza. Yes to Wing Street Wings. Yes to new stuffed garlic knots. And much more. It's easy to say yes to our first ever $5 flavor menu. Only at Pizza Hut.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
And welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium. Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice. And Bearcat just turned it over on an interception, but we had a hit in the back.
What a tough place for a shotgun quarterback to start.
And
Kevin,
we bring the house, as I thought we were at fumble.
There.
We'll see who got on it.
You know, it's better than a safety if
fumble
we fell on
play.
It.
Recovered by the Bearcats.
The Bearcats recover the fumble.
On the 6-inch line.
Yeah.
Is that
so big break for the Bearcats.
They're when you go into the shotgun there and we're just going to bring the rain then. That's easy.
Yeah, they brought everybody in the house, including the water boy.
Fusion, I was going to rush that
in
myself.
In-home care, providing assistance.
And I'd expect not to see anything too fancy here. The Bearcats will probably try to punch it in. And we got a timeout Bearcats, so we'll be right back.
Timeout Dexter.
Well, I apologize. We're going to stay with you right here. Winning on the football field doesn't happen by accident. Players and coaches work throughout the long summer, conditioning for the rigors of competition. Practice upon practice, the lessons learned by our Dexter student athletes will, however, serve them well for a lifetime. Lessons of discipline and teamwork, hard work and commitment to excellence. At Bank of Advance, we believe in the character that sports help to build, and we're proud to help support athletes on the field and in the classroom. Bank of Advance, where a handshake still matters. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender. So early on here, the Bearcats up 14-0.
There's a share a text with you from Bloomfield there, Kevin.
Here come the University of Arkansas hits. I would like to throw out there the Arkansas Razorbacks are 1-0. The
here
Mizzou
we go.
Tigers are 0-1.
That's
that is worth talking about.
Mark's a SEMO grad, so he won't get sucked into that.
So right here, the Bearcats with a chance to take it to a 3-score ball game. They lead 14-0, and this should be executed pretty easy on
straight
the half
ahead
yard line.
Do about whatever you want.
Hand off to Lawrence, and he should be in. Yep, and the official signals touchdown. So touchdown Bearcats by the sophomore, Hunter Lawrence.
There you go, Hunter.
Number 34, Hunter Lawrence takes it in for the score.
Hunter from a had him ID. We used to have to use him on the line a lot in the elementary ages because he was a bigger kid, but always had eyes on him as a potential fullback runner for for us as we got older. He's fast and low in that regard.
Well, and they say you can put just about every weight in the weight room on there, and he can squat it.
Yep.
Hand off to number 26, McDonald, and he gets in for the two-point conversion. So it was 7-11 to go here in the first half.
Good.
The Bearcats lead the Middle College Bulldogs 22-0. So just the start that Coach Gocher and his staff wanted to get tonight, they have. If you're just tuning in, a little bit of a recap. Right off the bat, the junior Nick Trout returned an interception 60 yards for a touchdown. Then the Bearcats come up with a good defensive play. Another interception by Nate Gargas, able to score again. And then just now the turnover by Middle College, they convert it. So right now three turnovers turned into three scores for the Bearcats.
It's making the coach's staff script look pretty good, Kevin.
Yes. We're speaking about elementary as that kicks off tomorrow morning, Lloyd.
Yep.
Got your third and fourth graders, your fifth and sixth graders. And
always a really fun time to see them out here, especially after a win.
They're pumped up.
Getting a little bit ahead of myself here, but I can. And I'm looking forward to seeing them guys go.
Oh, yeah, and I know my kids are pumped up about the Bearcat being in the middle of the field and all painted for them.
Absolutely.
Pooch kick there by Gerald.
There it is. Yep.
Now Bearcats cover well.
Pearson Ward on the return for the Bulldogs.
Bearcats with an opportunity there to possibly recover it, but Middle College hangs on to it.
Christian Yarber.
And they'll start at about the 41-yard line. We've not seen much offensively out of Middle College tonight. They have had a couple positive plays. We've seen them get to the – if they get to the corner, they've got speed. You know, they had the one big 30, 40-yard run called back for a hold. These Bearcats in a 4-3 look.
Just –
Gabe a little excited there, but Gabe come up with a big sack in the last series, and I'm sure he wants to – taste that again.
Yeah. Every time I see that on an NFL game, Kevin, it's never what you think it is, though.
Oh, yeah.
It's always a nod or a
– Yep.
But the official threw that to the left side, to the Dexter side, so.
Bearcats showing blitz.
Keep an eye on number five.
They do, and yep. He's – grabbed early, but still able to pick up a yard or two.
Richmond, the ball carrier.
So 6:52 to go here in the ball game. Bearcats lead 22-0. This is going to be second and about three for the Middle College Bulldogs. And Middle College, we said earlier, they're out of Memphis, Tennessee, private school there in Memphis, right down in the midtown of Memphis, close to the Liberty Bowl. Any of you that are familiar with Memphis, they're part of the Christian Brothers University heading. Coach Gotra, familiar with this team as he's coached in Tennessee.
There's a lot of movement there.
We'll get some of that yardage back.
False start.
As there's a false start by the Bulldogs. The Bulldogs, they come into this game 3-0. And, able to put up 42 points against Memphis Catholic, 49 points against another Memphis school, and then they won in week one 15-8. So
will we go on the road there next year, Kevin?
It's a question I've been asked, and I ask that same question. I've been told probably no, but I don't know who we'll replace that game with.
I kind of like the sound of that.
Yeah.
Road trip.
Oh, yeah.
Week three.
That's our backbreaker. Doesn't look like it's going to be enough for the first down, but it's going to be awfully close.
A coach over there trying to help him with the spot.
Nick Trout on the stop for the Bearcats.
I was told before the game that Middle College was fed tonight. Each kid got a whole chicken from on the go, so they got here about 5:15 and probably a good call by their coaching staff. You don't want to just walk off the bus onto the field
right.
And give your guys a chance to loosen
hot,
up.
hot trip up, and I'd have fed him a lot of heavy barbecue.
Yeah.
Good idea, whoever fed him.
It's a 4-3 look again, or more of a 4-4 look.
They kind of busted that one right in our teeth.
Yeah, and the Bearcats couldn't stand strong enough there. He's able to pick up the first down.
Good for a Bulldog first
Looks
down.
Like 51, Corey Holland, along with 68, Colton Gibson will come onto the field as 78, Luke Boyer, and number 64, Christian Yarber, will get a water break. We see Dr. Bobby Gibbon on the sideline, and we've said it time and time again, but we're just fortunate to have him on the sideline, him and Corey Blocker both, and they do it at a high price of free.
Plus, he has the sweetest set of auto magnets on his vehicle of anyone.
Yeah.
Oh,
big catch.
Nice catch. Yikes.
Yeah, and the big catch there by number 10, Rashad Robinson. And he's a 180-pound junior. He had to catch that backpedaling.
Yeah.
A great catch.
Number 32, Mason Kina
brings him down. The defense looks for the call from the sideline.
You know, flashes of that skill that on film you get a little worried about as a staff, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I mean, that's a good play.
Middle College, they started at about the 42, 43-yard line, and they're down to about the
38. We have had a quarterback switch. We are snapping it to the big fullback there.
Gabe Jackson brings him down, but not
easily.
That?
They pulled number two in there to.
Oh, yeah, a little bit of a switch.
He was brought down by number 35, Gabe Jackson.
See number 79 there on the offensive line for the Bulldogs. Thomas Donald, they list him at 6'4", 305, and I promise you he's every bit of it.
Yeah, he's three spins easily.
Middle College with a little bit of a spread offense here as they'll take it from shotgun. Three receivers, one in motion. Handoff, he'll make a cut, but number 44,
good
Austin Featherston right
there
and says absolutely not.
Filled that up in a hurry.
Davis, the ball carrier. Brought down by Jet Featherston, along with Bo McMullen.
Bo McMullen also in on the tackle. So it's going to bring second and about 11 up for the Middle College Bulldogs. And if you're just tuning in, I'm Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice. Our producer, Tyler Wagner, working hard back here as he says it's humid and hot. Middle College swings it out. It's caught. Bearcats come up and make the tackle. One tackle, miss two tackles.
Ah. Drives a coach's nut.
Pass complete number three, Destin Palmer.
Well,
no.
As a coach, I mean, even though we're up big in this game, you hate to see that kind of big yardage picked up. I mean,
you can't go arm tackling again. That's just bad for business.
Middle College, they're going to let the play clocks ran down to almost 10, 9. They'll get the snap off, but they're going to run it down. And movement by Middle College.
Yeah. Getting a couple of weather alerts around. Kevin, a couple games postponed. Let's not let that go on here.
Amen. You know, the Bearcats' first home game, we had a lightning delay against the Poplar Bluff Mules, and there was a good chance of some scattered storms today and tomorrow.
We dodged a bullet that night. I would have told you we were done. And
me too.
Yeah.
Well, several games that night were canceled and moved to the next day.
When it was about 180 degrees out.
Well, I listened to the Malden game on the radio the next day against Caruthersville, and it was right at 1 o'clock. Good Lord.
3-2. They're going to get a penalty.
Yeah.
Wait, we didn't get.
It's going to be the delay of game. So. Coach for the Bulldogs, not happy. With that, is it?
No.
You know, they were coming off a false start and then get delay a game. And they've actually had a little bit of momentum on offense here. They've moved the ball.
This is a coach drive you nuts scenario. A couple of good plays and then two costly penalties.
They'll go to the air.
Uh-oh.
He throws it deep. Almost got a hand on it, but defended perfectly by number 85, Nick Trout. He already has one returned interception for a touchdown.
Fourth down for the Bulldogs.
So we've got fourth and 15 or so for the Bulldogs, and I would think they'll probably go for it here as they're down 22-0 with two minutes to go in the half.
Not seen much of the punt game from them, so I'm going to guess they're in go for it territory.
They're going to have trips to the left and a single receiver to the right as one back in the backfield. They'll spread it out. Low snap.
Bad
he
snap.
Picks it up.
It's going to give us a break. It's a good ball.
Oh,
that
yeah.
way, guys.
Knocked down perfectly
yep.
by the Bearcats, number 21, Seth Rogers. Well, and we do not pass the ball much, but I'd be anxious to see if Coach Gotra will go to the air a little bit here.
Be a good time to try it out, wouldn't it?
You got a 22-0 lead going into half. Your defense has played well. I think I'd air it out. Work on some things. We need some two-minute plays as it is. I mean, we're heavily run offense. There may come a time when it's a close-score game and we need to score. We'll line up. One receiver right, McDonald in motion, and we do go to the air. Sindel throws it to his off-back, McDonald. He's immediately hit by the Bulldogs. I wasn't looking downfield there. Not sure.
I didn't see Ernesto get shook loose, but
no.
That play didn't start well and didn't end well.
Hey, right here, if it were me, I'd tell Gabe, just think I'm lobbing it to you in the paint. Go about 5 yards deep.
That's right.
Make him go get it.
He's an absolute specialist. If he can get a hand on it, Kevin, I can just about guarantee a reception.
Donald in motion again. Hand counter up the middle to Lawrence, or a trap, I should say. And he'll get back to about the line of scrimmage. Clock continues to run as it's going to be below one. Probably down to about a minute by the time we get this snap off.
Let's punch this in here, guys.
Well, you don't want to give the ball back to Middle College.
Nope.
Time clock's down to about 15 seconds. Riviera out wide here on the near side of the screen. Motion again by McDonald. Counter to Tennant, and he's got nothing but green in front of
Boy,
him.
He does.
He'll kick the speed in. He's down to about the 30, 25 before he gets knocked out of bounds.
Out of way, Peyton. Good.
And
Peyton, you talked about it, but he's already had game stats here in the first half.
Absolutely. He's approaching 100, I dare say, right now, easily. So
Bearcats with 46.8 seconds on the clock.
Just about right, Kevin. Wind this down. And
Gabe's out wide here, Lloyd.
There
look,
you go.
You
I like this
side.
Look. Do you have to declare that? You called it.
And he catches it down at about the 7-yard line.
He would have liked to have had a little better pass, Kevin.
Oh, yeah.
He kind of had to wait around for that. But
Coach Gocher's rushing him up to the line as the clock will stop to move the chains. 40.8 seconds
We're fine.
To go.
We're fine. Don't.
Yeah, they need to just relax.
Just relax.
See the band lined up below here. They look great in their new uniforms they got this year. We'll see what the Bearcats have as Gabe's out wide again.
Make sure we get
hand
out
off
of
the 10 and up the
go,
middle,
Peyton,
and he'll score, but we got a flag.
Ah.
I think Gabe might have lined
touchdown
up offsides.
Penalty flag on the play.
False start.
False start against the Bearcats.
We struggled there a little bit.
Huh?
We struggled there a little bit on our whatever cadence or putting a guy in motion. That's
and Gabe's defense,
that's
probably the first time all year he's been out wide.
So do you have to declare that? Is he in a right number for that or what's?
Yeah, he's in a right number
okay.
for it, and he will have
time
to.
Timeout.
And we got a timeout Bearcats. And we're going to stay here right now. Okay, I'm sorry. We'll be back in just a moment.
Fusion, the newest name in in-home care, providing assistance with any activity of daily living in the comfort and safety of your own home, including personal care, homemaker services, respite services, professional nurse visits, medication setup, and diabetic nail care. If you or someone you know is in need of care in their own home so they can remain there independently, then call us today. We serve New Madrid, Dunklin, and Stoddard counties. Fusion In-Home Care, building our family with yours.
Hi, I'm Shane Horner.
Hi, I'm Tim Ellison.
Hi, my name is Richard Clark.
I'm Lori Amos.
I'm Rob Blackwell.
And I'm Ryan Bassetti.
Hi, I'm Alan King.
Hello, I'm Larry Ellison, and we're proud to be part of the Harry Blackwell Ford family here in Malden, Missouri.
And welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium as the Bearcats are threatening to score again with 22.6 seconds left here in the first half.
Good possession on that 10 and run, Kevin, on the back of that.
Oh, great.
Peyton 10 and run. That's right down where we need to be. We're going to take this thing right into halftime.
And again, Gabe Jackson is lined up out wide, something you're not going to see very often. And we'll see if they go to the corner of the end zone. It could be a decoy.
It could be. Tatum.
No, they're going to go to him.
That's legit.
And they're going to be a flag there. Not,
he probably pushed off again.
Yeah. Penalty flag on the play.
We wait for the call.
Yeah, that was not catchable by any stretch.
Well, and that's that passing play, I would have to think, was designed to go up high and more
yeah,
of a straight
definitely.
Bullet throw. So 17 seconds left on the clock.
So, Kevin, was that a pass interference?
Yep, they caught a pass interference, so the Bearcats are going to have it at about the six, well, right on the six-yard line.
So you can have pass interference even when it's obviously.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Captain Obvious.
Run the counterplay to 10
a
and again,
bit too
but they're
jammed
all
up
over.
In there.
Bearcats take a timeout.
The ball carrier.
As there's 12.6
timeout.
Seconds left
Dexter.
On the clock. And we're going to stay right here with you. Bearcats lead 22-0, 12 seconds left on the clock. I'm Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice. And Lloyd, what do you think so far here in the first half?
Well, we get this one in, and I think we're going to have done just exactly what we wanted. Good aggressive early start. Two big defensive plays that make the game a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah.
Anytime you get a pick six and then an interception a couple of series later, kind of makes the game a little bit funner.
Yep.
Tell you one thing, they've not went away from the opportunity to throw to those guys. I mean,
nope.
they've steady tried to air it out on us. So.
Yep. Bearcats called the timeout to talk it over a little bit, and
we've got time
got a
for
big
two
lead,
more plays down
still
here,
kind
right?
Of a big score.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, we can get two in.
Got another timeout left.
We should have one left on the board. They're in a two tight, no motion. Gabe's wide open.
Yes, he is.
And he catches it.
Yeah.
Touchdown, Bearcats.
Just exactly what we said. It doesn't have to be real good for Gabe. He'll get a hand on it. Outstanding.
Gabe Jackson.
Ben Sindel going out to congratulate his big tight end, Gabe Jackson. Great throw by Ben Sindel there. 6 seconds to go, and the Bearcats lead 28-0.
Gabe makes a good target out there.
Oh.
That's good. Just get it in the general area and let him go to work.
And the Bearcats have put on a good show tonight. Is good home crowd out. A little warm still yet, but the temperature has come down a hair. And we'll see if the Bearcats can make it 30-0 here before the half. Motion by Tannen, and they'll hand it to him. He goes up the middle, but he stopped.
Conversion attempt, no good.
So outside of a return kick for a touchdown here, we should see the Bearcats go to the locker room with a 28-0 lead, and they get the ball as they deferred on the coin toss.
Good play call. Good, well done.
Yeah,
lined up. Double tight, you said,
yep.
So everybody's expecting to run. Very,
yep.
Very nice. Well done, man.
Bearcats tonight have only kicked one ball deep. They started off with an onside kick, two pooch kicks. We'll see. I really think they'll go deep here. 6 seconds on the clock unless they've seen something on film.
Jason's really got a good leg. I'd let him just kick this one out of the back of the end zone if he wanted. It's all he's doing. He might as well.
Yeah. Let him put a foot behind it. Jason, been kicking for the Bearcats
absolutely
since a freshman. And he's got the ability to kick some field goals if we get in that type of situation down the road. Senior will walk it off. Got Bo McMullen there up the middle. And we onside it again.
Jason went after that in himself.
And they're going to say Middle College did recover.
First and 10 for the
I have to think that they seen something on film because we're not kicking it deep very much.
Yeah, right.
One time
right
tonight.
Yeah, they've had to see something makes them a little suspect.
So this should be the last play of the half. You may see Middle College air it out here. Dexter's already lined up in a prevent defense as they've got four guys back.
Yeah, this is one of those nothing behind you.
Yep.
Coach screams for the entirety of the snap.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if they catch it on the five-yard line. Just
exactly.
Do not let them
right
get in the end zone.
They're going to run the ball.
Yeah, they're going to run it.
Make his tackle. If he's smart, he'll get out of bounds. There we go.
And time expires, so this is the end of the first half. Your Dexter Bearcats lead 28-0 over the Middle College Bulldogs.
Good
and we'll
half
be back in a little bit.
My name is Dustin Mayer. I operate Mayer Law Office, which is a full-service law firm located in Dexter, Missouri. I practice personal injury, criminal defense, workers' compensation, family, and other areas of law. As an assistant Missouri Attorney General and assistant prosecuting attorney, I've had the opportunity to try multiple cases in front of juries, and I'm willing to put that experience to work on your behalf. I'm a Southeast Missouri native, and if you hire me, you'll get the big firm experience with a small town touch. Call today for your free consultation.
Clear!
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Endzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
Hi, I'm Tyler Hubrecht, your state representative for the 151st District. The past two sessions that I've served in Jefferson City, I have fought against the attacks on gun rights. I have fought to support a foundation formula that can be fully funded for education. I've also fought for more support for infrastructure, in which we want in that, and getting more funding for our ports. I am now working to find ways to support our transportation and to fix our highways. I ask for your vote on November the 8th.
We at First National Bank proudly announce our new name, FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
When most banks change their name, new ownership is usually the case. This is not true with First National Bank. We have made the positive decision to streamline and update not only our name, but also our look. We have a fresh new logo, signage, lobby graphics, brochures, the works, with the same great service and friendly faces that you have come to expect and deserve. First National Bank is now FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
And folks, if you've not been to the Winchester Place, come in and take a look at this facility. You don't know what you have missed.
We are very proud of this facility. A lot of people do not realize we're here, what we can offer to them, and what a facility we have. And we would like to have people come by anytime and tour us. You won't find a better place to live or better staff to take care of you anywhere Southeast Missouri. I'll guarantee it.
We are located at 400 Winchester Drive. Come down Bowman, and we sit on the corner of Bowman and Winchester.
Rest easy. State Farm agent Chris Brannon is there for you. Call 573-624-1953 today for the service you deserve.
Introducing Pizza Hut's first $5 flavor menu. Just $5 each when you order two or more. Say yes to a medium one-topping pizza. Yes to Wing Street Wings. Yes to new stuffed garlic knots. and much more. It's easy to say yes to our first ever $5 flavor menu, only at Pizza Hut.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
And welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium. I'm Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice as we get ready to kick off the second half here. The Dexter Bearcats deferred on the coin toss, so they'll receive. And just like that, Bearcats out to a 28-0 lead. And I know Lloyd has some first half stats we'll hit you with here in a minute, but just a spectacular first half for the Bearcats, especially defensively.
Absolutely. The start we needed, the start we wanted. What a great finish to the half, our series that we went into the half with, just like the coaching staff drew it up.
Yep. Nick Trout got us started off with the 60-yard interception pick six. Middle College will kick it off, short kick. McDonald will pick it up. He looks for a seam, breaks it back up the middle. He weaves, he goes, picks up a few arms, stiff arm. He's still going. He's down to about the 44, 45-yard line. So good job by McDonald. There
good
wasn't
run back.
Much on that.
There wasn't. He made something out of nothing for sure, because that was starting to collapse there in the middle of the field, Kevin. Good
run
back.
Quick.
Point out to Mom at home, Joe Rice did get in the game on special teams, Mom. She can never tell, Kevin. It's she from bleacher level, you can't see it. So,
well, Joe, the sophomore, could be the quarterback of the future for the Bearcats.
In on a kick return, so.
Hey, if you get to see the field as a freshman or sophomore,
absolutely.
I think you should be happy.
Absolutely.
Pitch out to Hoggard. Hoggard will make a cut. Hangs on to the ball.
Caleb put his head down, ran downhill.
Caleb will pick up about 4 yards. And if you're a coach, you'll take 4 yards every play.
Every play.
Devin Polk.
What about the halftime meal there, Kevin? Mr. Bankin and the Hickory Log crew it upright, don't they?
Golly, I ate my weight in ribs. And Luke come over to get his cleats, and he stood there for a minute sniffing around. Then he
humming
finally
and
said,
hawing.
Can I have a rib? Send under center.
Fun tradition here at Dexter.
Wide
look
open
at
in
there.
The middle of the field is Caleb Hoggard.
He's
He'll take it all the way
zone.
To the house.
Atta, baby.
Touchdown.
Good read, Ben.
Yeah,
that was the second or third option. That's a good read downfield.
Outstanding job is a 40-yard pass for a touchdown.
That was not the initial play call. That's a good big boy play for Ben right there. Kick us an extra point here, too.
One thing I'll say about Ben Sendon, I kid you not, I had the kid, I think, in second grade in soccer. After that season, I told somebody, I said, he's going to be a great athlete for Dexter one day, because he's yes sir, no sir, works hard, doesn't complain. I mean, just you couldn't ask
one
for
of the
a
best.
Better kid.
Yep, one of my favorite all time. When we moved down here, Ben befriended Jake right away in the fifth grade, and it's a good boy.
And the kick is good, so the first extra point attempt by Gerald tonight is good as
that's
the Bearcats, a minute into the second half, lead 35-0. Tonight's game brought to you in part by Bagby Wealth Management in Dexter. Bagby Wealth Management is a fee-based advisory firm that specializes in giving investment advice, management, and financial planning services. When you're ready to pursue your investment goals, give them a call at 573-624-4771, and we appreciate the sponsorship by Mr. Bagby. We wouldn't be able to bring this to you without our sponsors.
Absolutely.
So we
it's a big deal.
You. And there's a lot of people. I'm the guy. I like going to the game, period. But there's several people during the week that tell me, hey, can't wait to watch the game on Friday night. Kick back in the recliner.
Well, with this kind of color commentary, I know it was on the website earlier. So
this is the best.
Ratings,
I mean, it doesn't get much better.
A ratings boom. Jason's shoes are just outstanding.
And we'll see another pooch kick. Middle College barely able to pick. Oh, he fumbles, but picked up by. I don't know. The Bearcats say they have it.
That's a Bearcat recovery.
And it is Bearcat ball.
Had a way to stay after it.
It looks like number one for the Bearcats, which is Ethan Martinez on the recovery. And this is Ethan's first year playing, as I'm just getting word. And
yep.
So,
that boy Ethan.
You know, normally in a situation like this, a lot of times you talk about the underclassmen getting to play, and we may see a lot of the JV here in just a bit. Which,
well, there's Joe Rice into the game, just as you called it.
Just right. So we were talking about Joe Rice, son of Lloyd and Heather Rice.
Don't screw it up, son.
Don't screw it up. I promise you his heart's beating 90 to nothing, but he just needs to relax.
No question. He is a real classic overthinker, Kevin.
And we line up in a little different look here as we've got both of our tight ends up as kind of a receiver situation. They'll pitch it to McDonald.
Again,
and he'll move forward.
Trevor just runs recklessly. He might weigh 140 pounds, and he runs into the teeth of that like he's a big boy.
Well, they list him at 150, but I know they had to have weighed him with his shoulder pads and his helmet on. But he runs the ball like he weighs 180.
Yeah, he really does. And again, another Trevor didn't play last year and running really confident for basically three games into his varsity career.
So the counterplay, Peyton drops it.
Following the ball.
Yeah. That's a number one no-no. Peyton's a playmaker, though, and he's wanting to make a play, but you always want to fall on that ball. And we'll wait for the call of the officials. Yeah, it will stay with the Bearcats.
Move on the play, recovered by Dexter.
They lose a little yardage there as they're back at about the original line in scrimmage, so it'll be about 3rd and 10 after the loss of 5.
Coach Sneed's rubbing his belly. Kevin, I'm anxious to see.
We'll see what the play call will be as they're lining Gabe Jackson out wide again. And somebody in the backfield immediately there is Joe was hit as soon as he got the snap, so.
Still wrestling for the ball.
That's going to be 4th down. The Bearcats are good.
Dexter, get on the recovery.
It looks like the Bearcats will punt. I thought we were maybe in the part of the field where we would possibly go for it. But, hey, your defense has played well. Pin them back deep.
That 40, Kevin, kind of seems to be a kind of a magic. Well, that didn't go well.
No, the punt by Ben Sandel.
For the love of Pete.
30-yard line, 1st and 10 from there.
So Coach Gocher had that to do over again. He might would have went for it.
Go ahead and go for it.
Only picked up about 10 yards with the punt. I tell you, I hate to rehash games, but the punt reminded me of it. Man, Popper Bluff had some guys that could just boot the ball. Of course, they have soccer over at Bluff, so.
You know, and how big a deal that is over the course of a series of games, especially that kicking game.
Bearcats blitz, and there's going to be a flag.
Yeah.
Gabe Jackson, Bo McMullen were both there early. They're going to call face mask against the Bearcats.
Flag
face mask against the Bearcats.
So with 8:20 to go here in the second half, your Dexter Bearcats lead 35-0 over the Middle College Bulldogs out of Memphis, Tennessee. Bearcats in the 4-3 look again. Handoff up the middle. He's tackled by number 41, Bo McMullen.
Braxton tangled up there with the back judge. That's
Richmond, the ball carrier. He was brought down by number 41, Bo McMullen.
What is that guy there in the middle, Kevin?
That'd be your middle linebacker.
No, the official that just got smashed.
Oh, I don't know.
You see him? He's standing over the ball now. Mark that for highlight, Caleb.
We got Caleb Ray here.
Spoofs.
Yeah. And a lot of times those guys, you've seen some of those guys get lit up or in the middle of the action.
There is, he's
up the middle again. And another flag. That's may see a hold there.
Richmond again, the ball carrier, brought down by number 45. Austin Adams, penalty flag on the play. Holding against the Bulldogs.
Yeah, we'll be holding. Looks like number 5, Blake Palmer, will check into the ball game for Braxton Foster.
Blake's a new senior, came out this year.
And I tell you, Blake is built like a machine.
He is.
I mean, he looks like a football player.
Good-looking kid. Wish he would have gotten the mix earlier. It's one of those. But glad to have him now. Good boy.
Middle College with trips right. They're going to go to the air here. Gabe Jackson in his face, screen.
Yeah, I'd get rid of it too.
And we got a flag.
Penalty flag on the play.
It's going to be against the Bearcats, I think, but.
That penalty will be declined.
Yeah, I'm not sure what the call was. I thought we might have been getting a sideline warning or.
He patted his head, if that. What is the head pat?
Yeah, that's, and he was pointing that direction.
Okay.
He pointed towards the backfield, so.
So
the legal
we declined.
Man downfield. Yeah, we declined.
We declined the penalty?
Yeah, so it's going to be 3rd and 15. Yeah. They run a screen pass, and a lot of times on the screen, it's easy to get an illegal blocker downfield. We'll swing it out to the right. He gets a little bit of a seam as we arm tackle, and he may pick
Kevin,
up 15, 16 yards, 20 yards.
Master of not knowing what I'm talking about, but I'd run that play against us. I mean, that's just been as effective as anything they've done. Tonight.
Well, if they've watched any film on us, and I'm not one to criticize our Bearcats, but that was certainly a play that
exactly.
we have not been able to stop. So you're right, Lloyd. I would, if I was the coach, I'd run it all night long until we tried to stop it.
Official timeout for Water.
We've got an official timeout for Water on the field, so we'll be back in just a moment.
Fusion, the newest name in in-home care, providing assistance with any activity of daily living in the comfort and safety of your own home, including personal care, homemaker services, respite services, professional nurse visits, medication setup, and diabetic nail care. If you or someone you know is in need of care in their own home so they can remain there independently, then call us today. We serve New Madrid, Dunklin, and Stoddard counties. Fusion In-Home Care, building our family with yours.
Hi, I'm Shane Horner.
Hi, I'm Tim Ellison.
Hi, my name is Richard Clark.
I'm Lori Amos.
I'm Rob Blackwell.
And I'm Ryan Bassetti.
Hi, I'm Alan King.
Hello, I'm Larry Ellison, and we're proud to be part of the Harry Blackwell Ford family here in Malden, Missouri.
Welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium. Again, Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice, and we just had an official timeout for water as your Dexter Bearcats lead 35-0 over the Middle College Bulldogs. 5:44 to go here in the third quarter. Middle College coming off the big first down, picked up about 20 yards.
Well, we had them pinned back there, Kevin. Yep. This possession started around the 30, and they lost yardage. And
well, the design quarterback sneak there. And
hello.
Gabe Jackson comes all the way across the field along with Peyton Tennant and number 45, Austin Adams.
Davis, the ball carrier.
Austin's had a couple of big licks tonight on special teams. Quick snap. They go deep down the field, and the quarterback just misses the throw, and we're lucky because he was.
But we were in trouble there. Yep.
He was wide open with nothing but green in front of him.
Yep. Overthrew him or little. Yep.
Yeah. Big defensive play.
Bulldog.
Brought down by number 51 in the backfield. Corey, the Bulldog.
Corey, you can't hear it on
yeah.
over the TV, but Aaron Mathis giving him a little lift, nicknamed Bulldog.
Yep. And another one of our favorites from Little League football and up. Corey's a good boy.
Corey Umps. You know, works at Park and Rec during the summer. Umped a lot of games. Always enjoyed having him.
Yep.
This will bring up fourth down for the Bulldogs. Bearcats with a stop here get good field position as the ball is about the 46, 47-yard line. They're going
Hello.
Nothing there. He gets crushed by Gabe Jackson. But nice job by Blake
Absolutely.
Palmer.
Blake Palmer applied the initial pressure there. And
Gabe Jackson on the stop. Turnover on down.
That was that whole blindside situation. Not exactly taking care of your quarterback there.
And they lost about 10 yards on that play.
Yeah, that was just ugly for him. That.
And the sophomore Joe Rice will come back out under center. Hoggard in motion, hands it off to him.
Good run, Caleb.
Hoggard, the ball carrier.
You know, the one thing about that play, Kevin, you really do have about a full head of steam by the time you're 4 or 5 steps into your motion. He's got a head of steam, one little gap. Well done, man.
I agree. They executed well, and you can tell these Bearcats are getting more and more comfortable.
Real comfortable with that. We're
motion again by Hoggard. Handoff up the middle to Lawrence.
Get a little forward progress spot.
Hunter Lawrence, the ball carrier, brought down by number 7, Tyrus Moore.
He's going to pick up about 2 yards by where they mark the ball. Coach Sneed calls in the play. Peyton Tennant still in the ball game at wing back. Along with Caleb Hoggard. Tennant in motion. They pitch to him. Nothing there.
Peyton Tennant on the carry. Brought down by number 16, Pearson Ward.
He was tackled by Pearson Ward. Peyton will come back out of the game as Trevor McDonald will check back in. Gabe Jackson looks on for the play. Gabe with a big touchdown reception
yeah.
late in the first half tonight.
I guarantee you he's putting the pressure on Joe for a, a second option out of this or something.
Third down. Joe Rice takes it. Counter.
There,
Hoggard
very nice.
Again.
Yeah.
First down.
Well done.
It'll be really close. Yeah.
Come on with that spot.
They might measure here. It looks like it'll be a first down. And they, the official does. No, they're going to call it a first down.
First down.
So two big runs on this series by the sophomore Caleb Hoggard. Got number 9, Joe Rice under center. Hunter Lawrence, the sophomore, in the backfield. McDonald go in motion. The pitch to McDonald.
Good read, Trevor. I don't know what gap that is exactly. What is that, Caleb? That
Jacob Hammer.
B gap.
Second down for the Bearcats.
Good, yeah, good read on it regardless, because from here it's awesome how you can just kind of see it open up and develop. And
yeah, kind of a design blast as you see the fullback.
Right. Get up. Not necessarily hole. Looking for big yardage, but.
Hoggard in motion. He'll get the call again. And good hard run.
Absolutely.
By Caleb Hoggard.
Going to give him a steady dose of that. That's
another first down.
Hoggard again on the carry. Brought down by number 2, Devon Pope. First and 10 for the Bearcats.
So they'll probably let the clock run down with about 5 seconds on, and they will. So we'll be back in just a minute to start the fourth quarter of play. Your Bearcats lead 35-0.
My name is Dustin Mayer. I operate Mayer Law Office, which is a full-service law firm located in Dexter, Missouri. I practice personal injury, criminal defense, workers' compensation, family, and other areas of law. As an assistant Missouri Attorney General and assistant prosecuting attorney, I've had the opportunity to try multiple cases in front of juries, and I'm willing to put that experience to work on your behalf. I'm a Southeast Missouri native, and if you hire me, you'll get the big firm experience with a small town touch. Call today for your free consultation.
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
And welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium as we're about to start the fourth quarter. Your Bearcats have the ball first and 10 as they're threatening to score. And
241 total yards so far piled up.
Well,
Kevin, good.
What's amazing about that, we talked about it at halftime,
yeah,
but we've had the short field all night.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's not a big broken play or anything.
This will be first down for the Bearcats. They're on about the 11 or 12 yard line.
Well, something happened.
Illegal motion, I think.
Ball started against the Bearcats.
Bearcats have actually been fairly penalty free tonight. I mean, they've had a handful, but nothing.
It's definitely not been an issue, and the first two games of the year was a much more pressing concern. Seemed to have gotten that figured out.
So the sophomore Joe Rice under center. Motion by Mason Keena. He'll take it up the middle. He's met by a slew of Middle College Bulldogs as they try to strip the ball from him. Mason able to pick up about a yard, yard and a half.
Mason Keena, the ball carrier.
Big passing down coming up, Kevin.
We'll see if they attempt to put it in the air. I'd love to see him throw it. Still got Gabe Jackson lined up. And more of a kind of like a hybrid receiver position as opposed to tight end. Hand off to Hoggard. He's still moving his feet. He's able to pick up about 3 yards.
The ball carrier brought down by number 7, Tyrus Moore. Third down for the Bearcats.
So we'll see if they attempt to put it in the air right here for the first time in the second half. Number 9, your quarterback Joe Rice comes to the sideline to bring the play in. Hunter Lawrence again in the backfield. Caleb Hoggard, Mason Keene at your wingbacks. They're going to call a false start against the Bearcats. A little bit of movement. It's going to be a third and about third and maybe 15. As the Bearcats can pick up the first down as the ball is first down marker is marked at about the 2 yard line. Joe Rice under center, Hunter Lawrence at fullback. Caleb Hoggard in motion. He'll take the pitch.
Give him one block, guys.
And he gets there a good seam. And
good, still
going
on his feet. There you go. Kick a field goal.
This is an outstanding time to kick a field goal. Give Gerald the chance.
Yep.
We can hear the Dexter Bearcat student section getting fired up. Still late here in the game.
Might go with the old long snap.
Yep. See if he can pull them off sides.
Count and then.
They break the huddle. It's going to be fourth and about 5 here. Hoggard motion, snaps. Give it to him again. He's been a machine, and
he's
get in
for the
score. He's just
trucked his way.
They're going to whistle him down, but it looks like he may be down. Might have been enough for a first down.
Brought down by number 66, Christopher Difference.
Should be a first down.
Still
Kevin
waiting
Lesheim
for the call from the official. And first down. So it'll be first and goal for your Dexter Bearcats. As we get under 9 minutes to go here in the game.
He is, yeah.
Yeah, Gabe.
Joe has a decision here. Listen to coach or listen to Gabe.
Yeah, Gabe was campaigning pretty hard.
Yeah, me. Pick me. We'll see who wins.
Gabe still lined up outside. Hoggard motion, and they'll hand it to him.
Nice.
He'll walk it in.
Yep.
So touchdown, Bearcats. They'll go up 41-0.
Set off the cannon.
With 8:28 to go here in the first half.
Good possession there, Kevin. Ate up a lot of clock.
Yeah, they able
grinded
to eat up a lot
it around,
of
worked down the field.
Big runs by Caleb Hoggard. Coach rewards him by letting him finish it off for the touchdown. Gerald will line up for his second extra point attempt tonight. First one good by a mile.
Seems like they might ought to put up a one worth a little more. Oh, a bad.
I jinxed him. That would have been.
Nah, it was a weird hold or I don't. Bad snap, bad hold, something.
If you take a nice look at the field tonight, you should be impressed as it's in great condition thanks to Turf Renovations. Turf Renovations is responsible for outstanding field surfaces on not only this field, but numerous ones in the area such as Dexter, Sykeston, Portageville, and area baseball fields as well. Turf Renovations prides themselves on providing the best playing surface possible for the area's athletes. Special thanks to Turf Renovations, and to check out their projects, go to turfrenovations.com.
Kevin,
the Bearcats, go ahead,
swings
Lord.
Me over to the new baseball field project that's going on down at the East Park. If you got a chance, folks, to go by there, that is going to be a hidden little gem while people figure out how nice that field's going to be. The baseball field within the next couple of weeks is really going to look special down there. Take a look at it.
Yeah, you're right. I've not got the chance to go down and look at it, but, you know, the city and the school able to work out
yes,
an agreement.
Really, really tickled with the cooperation and Mr. Wood kind of leading the way on that. And just appreciate everybody that's gotten involved in that. We're going to have us a really good baseball field down there.
So the Bearcats kick it deep for only the second time tonight. And good open field tackle there by number 44, Featherston.
Way to get down there, Jet. Jet's got a great football name, by the way.
So this Bearcat defense has been stout all night long. We'll see if they continue to play hard. Looks like your starters are still in the game, as the Bearcats lead 41-0 here late in the game. The clock's running now. 8 minutes, 5 seconds to go here in the ball game. And he finds the seam,
uh-oh,
and he might take it to the house. He's got one guy to beat. He's
now
at the 40, makes a cut at the 30,
oh,
and he's
going
to score 20-10. Touchdown, Middle College Bulldogs.
Number six, Keyshawn Davis.
And it'll be 41-6 as they're able to put points on the
penalty
scoreboard for the first time.
Flag.
There is a penalty.
Whoa.
Oh, it's going to be called back. It'll be a holding.
Oh, no.
holding against the Bulldogs. So, really, Middle College has had two big plays tonight.
Yep.
Negated by two holding calls, so.
Well, the white hat called it, and he's got that view of it. I mean, it must have been the real deal.
Oh,
I see his coach over there giving him the player some grief about it and showing him the technique, so.
Well, and when your defense has played this well all night long, this late into the game, you expect some holds. I mean, you're doing all you can to keep them out of the backfield.
Right, yeah,
so.
At this point, I'm tired of wrestling with this guy, and.
So
or as our good friend at Bloomfield, Mark Wethington, would say, wrestling with this guy.
Wrestling. We got the score from Memphis. That reminds me of old Handsome Jimmy. He always said Memphis, Tennessee. So.
Yeah.
And he slips. And there's going to be an unfortunate flag, it looks like, against the Bulldogs, possibly.
It'll be a classic call it on both, I'm sure.
Yeah.
But I did not stick it up for my boy Nate Gargis, probably, but that was not on him.
Well, and I seen Coach Gocher pointing early.
Yeah.
That's what drew my attention to across the field. So,
Ed, you can be comforted in knowing, even if they do the old double penalty routine.
Yeah,
baloney.
They're going to make it offsetting penalties,
yeah.
But
offsetting personal foul.
Coach Gocher not happy about that call. I mean, you got a 41-0 lead,
right.
But still, yeah, you don't want your player to get called for that.
Yep.
So it's going to.
I'd left him in too, and I'm harsh about that. Kevin is a fellow official, but.
Yeah, I think he might have been a late look by the official,
yeah.
And so he thought.
We'll go with that.
First and, it'll be first and about 18, 19. I'll call it second and 20, I apologize. Bearcats still in the 4-3 look, as I'm seeing a couple subs. Mason Keenan into the ball game on defense, and gosh, nice tackle.
Davis brought down the backfield by number 68.
Good tackle.
Yeah, that was just a great tackle by
anyway, Colton. There you go, big fella.
Looks like Gargis will check out of the game. Number 3, Ernesto Riviera, check into the ball game. So third forever for the Middle College Bulldogs. They go to the air. He connects, but not enough for the first down. It's going to be fourth and about three.
Seth Rogers, that's well played,
yeah.
Kevin. Nothing behind you. Don't gamble. And now if they go for it, make them pay for it.
Yeah, if the Bearcats are able to get a stop here, they'll certainly have excellent field position.
I mean, this is on the ball, fellas. Make sure we don't get jumpy.
Ball marked at about the 29-yard line. Bo trying to pep his defense up a little bit here.
Yeah, we need to stop here, guys. Good.
And they
good.
Get it.
Good.
So the Bearcats should take over on downs. We see Gabe Jackson.
Jam that up, fellas. Good job.
I'm not sure what the confusion is. It looks like he's nowhere near close to the first down.
Official timeout for measurement.
We'll call the...
They're going to measure, but...
If it is, Aldridge was holding the sticks, and he's completely fallen asleep at the wheel.
Yeah.
First and 10 for the Bearcats.
There you go.
Yeah, they didn't even make their way out to the ball.
Right,
I think they figured out quick. It was about a yard short.
Official timeout. Water.
So we've got an official timeout for water. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Tyler Hubrecht, your state representative for the 151st District. The past two sessions that I've served in Jefferson City, I have fought against the attacks on gun rights. I have fought to support a foundation formula that can be fully funded for education. I've also fought for more support for our infrastructure, in which we want in that, and getting more funding for our ports. I am now working to find ways to support our transportation and to fix our highways. I ask for your vote on November the 8th.
We at First National Bank proudly announce our new name, FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
When most banks change their name, new ownership is usually the case. This is not true with First National Bank. We have made the positive decision to streamline and update not only our name, but also our look. We have a fresh new logo, signage, lobby graphics, brochures, the works, with the same great service and friendly faces that you have come to expect and deserve. First National Bank is now FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
And welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium. As we wind down this game, I'm Kevin Bishop alongside Lloyd Rice, and the Bearcats just took over on downs.
Definitely a JV look to this 11, Kevin.
Yeah,
as
we got
continue the storybook rhymes.
Yeah. There's a pitch. Looked like maybe to Keena, but he was met immediately at the line of scrimmage.
Pearson Ward on a stop for the Bulldogs.
Bring
Brody
up about
Pollock
second.
Into the game. Chris Reinhart.
And that might have been Reinhart on that carry, so I apologize. Ken and Christie, if I missed that. And it looks like it possibly was as Reinhart and Keena lined up at the wing backs.
Uh-oh.
Good cut.
There you go, Mason. Stay on your feet, big man. Attaway.
And he's still going.
Now that
be a flag.
Is a way to battle.
Most likely going to be a face mask.
Mason Keena, the ball carrier. Penalty flag on the play.
As we'll see, number 15, Jake Rice, and number 52.
Now, Kevin, you know what we got to have. We got to have a Rice-to-Rice
situation. Oh, man, how awesome
situation.
Would that be? That would be awesome. This is going to be first down. Jake Rice is out wide to the left. Chris Reinhart lined up at fullback.
Whoa.
Oh, wide
open. A lot of green. Attaway, Chris. Atta, baby.
Chris
down your feet. There's a lot of green space there, Kevin.
Oh, he did. He was able to pick up about 12 yards, and nobody touched him. So good job by the offensive line.
Joe just barely got rid of that right in the nick of time. So
the Bearcats with an opportunity to increase their lead here as the ball is on about the four-yard line. They're going to say two-yard line. Hand off up the middle.
Good night. Now we've got full-blown punches thrown.
And there's the flag.
Penalty flags on the play.
That should probably result in an ejection by that young man.
Yeah. His teammates trying to tell him don't be stupid, I'm sure.
I don't know what the rules are for an out-of-state team, but that would be a, yeah, of course.
He is ejected. I know in most high school athletic associations, that means you're out the next week too.
It would if it carries over or if they – Yeah, I mean, it would reciprocate in Missouri, I know that. You would report it and let their state association know.
Offsetting penalties.
What about that offsetting penalty last night in the Denver game? Did you see it late?
I didn't. I got to see a recap on SportsCenter, but Denver with the surprise win last night.
Oh, my goodness.
So we got offsetting penalties of unsportsmanlike conduct. I'm not sure why we moved back. Right.
Then we've got another one called on top of it.
Oh, okay. So we.
So.
Well, a lot of frustration if you're middle college. I mean, you come in 3-0, you're 3 hours from home, and you find yourself down 41-0. Frustration got the best of them, and we'll wait for the officials to start the clock here.
I never quite understood throwing a punch in football, Kevin.
Yeah, I mean, I don't either.
What are we going to hit?
Yeah, you're going to hurt yourself worse than you are the other person. Motion.
Get around him.
Good stiff arm, but
yeah,
that's going to be another face mask.
Obviously going to be a face mask. Good night.
Keep it the ball carrier. Penalty flag on the play.
You know, one thing about it, Kevin, it's easier to tackle a guy if you grab those face mask bars.
Yeah, they come
and
down
hang on
a little easier.
Face mask against the Bearcats.
Oh, okay. My bad. Yep. Now you can put your hand on the face mask. You just can't
close
grab
the grip.
It.
Yep. Not sure why the clock's not continuing to run here, because I thought we would be under the mercy rule, but 3:20 to go. Bearcats lead 41-0. And second down and goal for the Bearcats, although the ball is at about the 20-yard line, a couple penalties. And it'll be a fumble on the play, and Middle College recovers. So 2:55 to go here in the ball game. The Dexter Bearcat defense will come back onto the field.
I tell you what's throwing you, Kevin, Reinhardt's wearing 20, not 22.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah,
It's not on the roster.
I can tell that's Chris there. So finish up here, gang.
Most of your starters still in the ball game on defense. I see Gabe Jackson checked out. Still have Big Bo McMullen up the middle. And he'll have Mason Keena and Austin Adams helping him out the linebacker position. Middle College, they're going to throw the swing pass.
Good read by Adams.
Great read.
He just missed the tackle, but he really had a good read on that play.
Pass complete, number five.
Yeah. And I'm sure when they watch that film, coach just going to say, hey, outstanding job, but finish it. Close
right.
Off. Seth Rogers. Able to finish off the tackle. Seth had a good game tonight.
Absolutely.
A couple of deflections.
A
We're under 2 minutes here to go in the ball game. So Bearcats, in big fashion, are going to be 2-2 on the year. Two more home ball games scheduled. Middle College swings it out again.
Bubble screen. Handled a little better, but.
Yeah.
All right.
It looks like Bo McMullen went in and finished that off.
Went in and finished up the.
Bo McMullen on the stop for the Bearcats.
Looks like number 60, Ryder Foster, will check into the ball game for the Bearcats as we see number 77, Noah Rushing, comes off the field. Noah's another one I had in T-ball several years ago. I think I'm starting to feel old, Lloyd. All these
probably so. Yeah, you're dating yourself there.
Yeah. Middle College will pick up the first down, but good defense by the Bearcats. Number one, Ethan Martinez. Along with number 70, will check into the ball game. And I apologize, we don't have a 70 on the roster. And we got a timeout. Middle College Bulldogs. We'll be right back.
And folks, if you've not been to the Winchester Place, come in and take a look at this facility. You don't know what you have missed.
We are very proud of this facility. A lot of people do not realize we're here, what we can offer to them, and what a facility we have. And we would like to have people come by anytime and tourists. You won't find a better place to live or better staff to take care of you anywhere Southeast Missouri. I'll guarantee it.
We are located at 400 Winchester Drive. Come down Bowman and we sit on the corner of Bowman and Winchester.
Rest easy. State Farm agent Chris Brannon is there for you. Call 573-624-1953 today for the service you deserve.
And we're back at Charles Bland Stadium as we're about 38 seconds from closing out this game, and the Dexter Bearcats will pick up their second win of the season, 41-0 right now, and they've been able to hold the Middle College Bulldogs out of Memphis, Tennessee, scoreless. And if you're the Middle College Bulldogs, you'd love to punch it in just for a face.
Just
right here.
That's right.
They had trips right. They're going to go downfield. Couple missed tackles there, but eventually brought down by Ernesto Riviera. And the Bearcat student sections giving their final cheers as the Bearcats will close out here. Winning on the football field doesn't happen by accident. Players and coaches work throughout the long summer, conditioning for the rigors of competition. Practice upon practice. The lessons learned by our Dexter student athletes will, however, serve them well for a lifetime. Lessons of discipline and teamwork, hard work and commitment to excellence. At Bank of Advance, we believe in the character that sports help to build, and we're proud to help support athletes on the field and in the classroom. Bank of Advance, where a handshake still matters. Member FDIC and equal housing lender. So, first and 10 here for the Middle College Bulldogs. 25 seconds on the clock, and I'm still unsure as to why the clock's even. Of course, we're coming off a timeout, but
right.
I'm not seeing the clock stop or continuously to run for the mercy rule. They'll go to the air again.
Uh-oh.
And he nearly
stepped. Nothing behind you.
Oh, and he almost was able to bring
it
in.
He did everything but catch it.
Good defense by the freshman Peyton Hillis. Kind of break that up. And the quarterback from Middle College was really close, and that is going to run the, well, Middle College, they're going to call a timeout with 2 seconds left on the clock. I guess they're wanting to get every opportunity they can to put some points on the board. And if I'm Middle College, I'm thinking I got a three-hour ride home. Let's go to the house.
Absolutely thinking the same thing. There you go. That's, coach is going to put a little more length in to least get the ball knocked down. Crap, if you catch it at this point, run it back, Kevin.
Oh, yeah. Just go. Coach Goldtra giving some final instructions. And if nothing else, this is for your defense. You're telling them, hey, you've held these guys scoreless. Do not let them put points on the board. So
right.
Bearcats are going to put in their prevent defense as they've got six guys basically back deep. Your linebacker, Bo McMullen, is going to line up about 10, 12 yards deep. Time expires. Middle College will run it out. He's going to be knocked out of bounds at about the 30-yard line. So,
final score.
Big win for the Dexter
big
Bearcats.
Big win. Well done, men.
Final score, 41-0 against the Middle College Bulldogs out of Memphis, Tennessee. We'll be back in a minute with some final stats.
Introducing Pizza Hut's first $5 flavor menu. Just $5 each when you order two or more. Say yes to a medium one-topping pizza, yes to Wing Street Wings, yes to new stuffed garlic knots, and much more. It's easy to say yes to our first ever $5 flavor menu, only at Pizza Hut.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
Welcome back to Charles Bland Stadium, and 41-0 victory by the Dexter Bearcats tonight. You know, Middle College in here out of Memphis, Tennessee. Lloyd come into the night 3-0 and some impressive points on the board.
Absolutely.
But the Bearcats, they said they wasn't scared, and they come out all, you know, quick and early and able to set the tone for the game, and big win for Coach Gotra.
Yeah, absolutely. Probably did what you wanted, needed, expected to do. Yeah. As a coaching staff, didn't, you know, play down to the level of competition or anything like that. I just thought they brought it, Kevin. Kind of shared the ball around, did some different things. Really fun plays, big plays early, defensive, which spark, you know, the whole attitude of the team. Just well done. Congratulate them on a good effort getting out here and taking care of business.
I agree. Early on, you know, Nick Trout, I think maybe the second play of the ball game, and we were barely a minute into the ball game, interception, pick six, runs it back 60 yards for the touchdown. Very next series, the sophomore Nate Gargis, you know, does a great job of reeling in an interception on the sideline. We score again.
Right.
Like you said, we got to see a big pass to Gabe Jackson in the end zone tonight. They, you know, lined him up. You know, it was more like a receiver as opposed to a tight end, and you know, overall, I think when they watch film, they're going to see we did a lot of good things offensively and defensively. Just a real complete game, I thought.
The stat nerds have us down for three sacks, one each by Gabe Jackson, Blake Palmer, and Braxton Foster. Yeah. And those guys, there was a lot of pressure going on even when it didn't result in an official sack too, Kevin.
Yeah.
Bo McMullen looks like lettuce in tackles. For the night. But again, so many people get to play in a game like this, Kevin. The Bearcats with 281 yards of total offense, 216 of those on the ground. Like I said, Joe getting to play in the second half kind of gives us a different look. And we're going to be run heavy at with him in there. But a lot of the JV guys get in to finish up the game. And again, you're seeing a lot of those future names that we hope getting called. Got a lot of touches tonight.
Yeah, we sure did. I mean, we've seen Caleb Hoggard run the ball about as good as any sophomore tonight.
Yep.
You know, Mason Keena, the freshman in, got several carries. And, you know, outstanding job to the senior, Peyton Tennant. I mean,
absolutely.
He played
yep.
– he had a complete game himself tonight. You know, a lot of yards on the ground, played well defensively early on. I remember him having a big hit in the backfield. And, you know, that, like I said, tonight's a good night for all the Bearcats. Several of the JV guys got in there to play and did well when they got in there.
Got Caleb Hoggard down for 79 rushing yards. Peyton Tennant was 65. And I know Peyton was in the 70s in the first half and probably – had a few dropped in the backfield
yeah.
there in the third quarter. Went a little bit negative against him. Hunter Lawrence had a nice little game. Carried the ball for 27 yards. Mason Keena got some carries for 11 yards. Chris Reinhart came in late and had a 13-yard run,
yeah.
which should have been in the end zone. Horrible spot by
yeah.
the officials. So we'll pin that one off on them. And, again, just kind of taking care of business if you're the coaching staff. Exactly what you want done.
Yeah, I agree. Fun game to commentate tonight. Again, I'm Kevin Bishop. We had Lloyd Rice alongside Caleb Bray running our camera and our faithful producer, Tyler Wagner. Join in as I think we'll be back in 2 weeks maybe. I don't have the schedule in front of me, but I think we alternate home away this year for the most part. But we're signing off tonight. Everybody have a good, safe weekend. We appreciate you tuning in.